Welcome back to Radial Dynamics. Today we're going to be talking about my favorite topic, which is steering reservoirs. Now, in one of my last videos, I showed you exactly what happens inside of my patented vortex reservoir using a clear acrylic model flowing water up to 15 gallons per minute. Today I'm going to run that same exact experiment on a competitor's reservoir using this unit here, which is one with an integrated spin-on filter. Now, I've already replaced the canister portion of the reservoir with clear acrylic so that we can also see what's happening inside of here. And if we take a quick look at the detailed design of this reservoir, we'll notice a few key differences, mainly in the fact that this particular reservoir with the spin-on filter on the bottom, as fluid comes in from the two return ports, there's a main return and then an auxiliary return for an external pressure relief valve or hydro boost. Fluid is going to travel through this annular area here, through the filter, and then up into the center threaded portion. And it's going to take a 90 degree turn heading straight back out to the pump. We can see that at the bottom of the reservoir here, at the bottom of the canister, there's only a single passageway that connects the canister to the outlet. And what's happening in this reservoir is that as the pump is operating and moving fluid through your system, all of your flow is just moving through this base, but it's not circulating up in the canister. So you could have, on a model like this one, up to a quart of fluid sitting in the upper portion of the reservoir. That's not really contributing to your steering system. It's not helping to absorb and dissipate energy from the pump. It's more or less sitting there stagnant. The other downside to this is that if there happens to be any air or any gas bubbles in your steering fluid, then as the pump operates, the fluid velocity going through this base is so high that any entrained bubbles won't have a chance to escape and rise up to the top of the reservoir. They'll just keep making that turn and heading straight back out to the pump. So what we're going to do today is hook this reservoir up to the same water pump with the same control valve as the past experiment and see how this one compares. Okay, so a few observations that I made during that experiment that I just wanted to comment on. Number one was how difficult this reservoir was to bleed air out of the system compared to the vortex reservoir. One of the things that you may have noticed during the test was that when I opened up this valve to ingest air into the system, the fill level actually increased in the reservoir, and that was because that air was displacing water in the pump and in the plumbing in the system. And as long as that pump was running, The air was just continuing to circulate in the system. It never had a chance to escape. It wasn't until I shut the pump off that air was able to then bubble up to the top of the reservoir, and we saw the fill level come back down. Even beyond that, once air did initially bubble out, there was still air trapped in the system. I had to then fire up the pump for just a few seconds, let all of the remaining air get pushed through the filter into the suction line, or the hose that feeds the pump, and then shut it back off again so that I could then let that air bubble back up out of the reservoir. Finally, because of the fact that this reservoir only allows air to escape the system when the pump is off and there's no flow moving, that means that in order for that air to work itself out, the hose that's exiting the reservoir and heading down to the pump has to be at a downward slope so that any air bubbles are able to work their way back up to the reservoir. That wasn't the case with the Vortex reservoir, since it self-bleeds the system anytime that the pump is flowing. So if you have one of these types of reservoirs in your vehicle, just keep that in mind, whether you're filling your system for the first time and doing an initial bleed, or if you just replaced a component, you might have some residual air in the system that you have to get out. It's going to be a somewhat tedious process to get that air out of the system with this type of reservoir. So thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this demo, and I'll see you next time.